Okay, and let's create a new composition, and we're going to call this source text. And I'm at 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, and 10 seconds long, and click OK. Now, Command or Control T to bring up your text tool. I'm going to type cool stuff with text. Right-click on this layer, go to Transform, Center, Anchor Point, Layer Content, or you can use the shortcut. And let's go to our Align panel and let's align this to the center of our composition. This effect works really good with a thick, fat font. As you can see, I'm using Gilroy Heavy, and I'll be including this font in the project file so you can use that. Okay, so we're going to be using text animators. If you're not familiar with text animators, I've done a ton of tutorials on them. And actually, I have a playlist that's dedicated solely to text animators. So I highly encourage you to check that out if any of this seems unfamiliar to you. Go to your Animate button and we want to enable Per Character 3D. Animate button again. Let's add in a position text animator. And I'm just going to go through these real quick and change these settings. We want our position. This will be our starting position. We want to pull this back towards us until it's off screen. About negative 2700. Go to randomize order. We want to turn that on. Ease low set to 100%. Let's change our shape from square to ramp up. And now we want to make our starting offset percentage negative 100%. Put a keyframe, go forward about a second, and increase that to 100%. Okay, so we have this type of animation here. Okay, so let's go down to about maybe 7 seconds, and let's just copy these keyframes, copy and paste. Then let's right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse. So that way we reverse the animation. So it's going to come in like this, sit for a few seconds, and then it's going to animate out just like that. I'm going to use this as a pre-comp, so that way you can change your text and still get the effect. Everything will update automatically. So I'm going to take this source text pre-comp and drag it into this create a new comp icon. So that way it creates a new composition. I'm going to change source text to animation. Go to your effects and presets panel. If you go under your animation presets and go under presets, After Effects comes stock with some really cool animated backgrounds. Now, you can go through here and kind of experiment with these. The one I'll be using is called Magma. So I want to make sure my playhead is at the beginning of my animation because this has keyframes. And if you just double click on Magma, it will add it to a solid. And if you hit U, you can see keyframes have been brought in. I'm going to go ahead and move this second set of keyframes all the way to the very end. Scrub through here, we can see what this Magma preset looks like. And as you can see, the main driving force is this fractal noise, and it's got a tritone and levels. Now, you can adjust all of these if you want. I'm going to leave all these settings to the default settings that After Effects is already included. Okay, now I'm going to change the name of this solid layer to Magma because we always rename our layers. Let's pull Magma underneath our source text and go to your track mat and let's just alpha mat source text. So that way our Magma shows up inside of our text like that. Okay, so let's duplicate source text, turn that layer back on, move it underneath Magma, and we're going to add in a few layer styles. So go to layer, layer styles, and add in an outer glow, and then layer, layer styles, add in a stroke. Okay, so let's open these settings up. I'll make some changes here. First, let's go to our outer glow. We want to make our opacity 60%. Our color defaults to this yellow. We want to make it kind of like a deep orange like that. And we're going to change our size from 5 up to 50. So now let's go down to our stroke, and it defaults to red, so let's make that black, and we'll change our size to 5. So I'm going to close all that up. I'm going to duplicate source text again and open up our bottom source text. And the only thing I'm going to change here is our stroke. Change our stroke from this black to a yellow. I'm going to increase my stroke size, we'll say, to about 8.5. Now, this is all personal preference. You can make these colors whatever you'd like. You can make the stroke thickness whatever you like. For this example, these are the settings I'm going to use and watch it play back. And we can kind of see how our text has this magma inside of it and has this kind of cool, glowy, thick stroke that's going around it. Okay, so I'm going to close all that up. I'm going to grab this animation pre-comp, and I'm going to drag this one into create a new composition. Again, this icon right here. So now let's rename animation to final. Okay, so now let's make this layer 3D. And then I want to duplicate animation. I'm going to rename this bottom copy to reflect. Hit R for rotation. I'm going to change our X rotation to 180 so that way it's flipped upside down. P for position and just drag this underneath our original text. Okay, so now press T for opacity and we're going to make this 33%. And we want to go up to effect, blur and sharpen and add in a fast box blur. Okay, so let's repeat edge pixels. We want our blur dimensions to be horizontal only. And I'm going to make the blur radius 15, so that way it kind of has this wide-looking blur like that. Command or Control Y to create a new solid, and let's change this from black to like a red. Okay, and then we go to our Effects and Presets panel, and we want to type in Fractal for Fractal Noise, and just double-click Fractal Noise. And now the only change I'm going to make to this is I'm going to change my blending mode from normal to multiply. Okay, so now let's rename this to floor, and we want to make it 3D. And now let's pull this underneath our other layers, P4 position, and let's just go ahead and bring this down underneath everything else. With floor selected, let's go to Effect, Blur and Sharpen, Fast Box Blur, repeat our edge pixels, set our blur dimensions to horizontal, and now let's make this blur radius, we'll say 500, like that. I want to add in a background to this, so Command or Control Y to create another solid. We're just going to call this BG for background. The color doesn't matter, bring it to the very bottom. The reason why it doesn't matter is because we're going to go to Effect, Generate Gradient Ramp, swap the colors, change our ramp shape from linear to radial, and then let's make this white. We're going to make this kind of like a deep red. And now let's go back to our floor layer and hit T for opacity. Let's just bring this down about maybe 50%. Add in our camera movement. So we want to go to Layer, New Camera. And it doesn't really matter for this example what camera settings you have. Just click OK. Layer, New, Null Object. Okay, so now let's rename the null object to Camera Control. Let's make this camera control layer 3D, and then let's parent our camera to the camera control. Hit P to bring up your position on your camera control settings. I'm just going to go ahead and put a keyframe there. Our text will animate out around 7 seconds. I'm just going to push in, so that way we just kind of have this simple little animation. And now you can do all kinds of stuff with this. You can hold down Shift and press R to bring up your rotation. You can, you know, mess with your Y rotation, your X rotation. I'm just going to leave this as a straight on shot. And then let's move this last keyframe down, so that way our camera's going to stop after the animation. You want the animation out to be completed before your camera stops, so maybe about 8 seconds. And I'm just going to right-click, choose Keyframe Assistant, Easy Ease In, and let's watch that playback. And now again, the reason why I wanted to pre-comp our text layer, if we go back to this source text pre-comp, now I can change this to anything, so I'm going to say 7 minute AE tutorials. And if we go back out to our final comp here, we can see that it updates automatically. So you can do some really cool things with the settings. I recommend that you always pre-comp your source text. That way you can change it to whatever you want and you retain that animation. Go through the backgrounds that come stock with After Effects. There's some really cool animated backgrounds that After Effects gives you. And you can always tweak the settings. You can change the colors. You can change the way things animate. But just take a look at that and see what you can come up with.